Good morning and welcome to the TAS Morning Show. Following a 10-wicket win against PNG, hosts Oman will face Bangladesh in the second game of ICC T20 World Cup at 6 p.m. in Al Amrat Cricket Stadium on Tuesday. Oman are one of the favourites to qualify for the Super 12 stage. They won their previous match comprehensively against PNG by 10 wickets. Akib Ilyas and Jatinder Singh scored 50 not out and 73 not out respectively. Oman were able to chase down a target of 130 in just 13.4 overs. Bangladesh faced an upset against Scotland in their previous match. Bangladesh fell short by 6 runs while chasing a target of 141. Bangladesh will be looking to bounce back with a win against Oman as they are eyeing the Super 12 stage. Their remaining fixture is against PNG, which should give them some confidence. His Majesty Sultan Haitham bin Tariq, the Supreme Commander of the Armed Forces, has issued a special royal pardon to 328 prisoners, including 107 expats, the Oman News Agency reported on Monday. In a statement issued on Sunday, ONA said the royal pardon coincides with Prophet Muhammad's birthday and in consideration of families of the prisoners. The total number of small and medium enterprises registered in the Authority for Small and Medium Enterprises Development till the end of August 2021 has increased by 24%. In a statement issued by National Centre for Statistics Information, there are 56,687 institutions. The number of micro, small and medium enterprises registered with the Small and Medium Enterprises Development Authority at the end of August 2021 increased by 24% to reach about 56,687 institutions, according to the data issued by the National Centre for Statistics and Information. Oman News Agency informed. Oman Air is planning to replace its older aircraft with newer planes that offers greater fuel efficiency and fewer emissions, Abdulaziz Al-Raisi, Chief Executive Officer of the National Airline, said. Al-Raisi said severe reduction in global passenger demand caused by the pandemic as well as travel restrictions across its networks have led to a temporary suspension of some routes. As vaccination rates pick up globally, we aim to increasingly reopen our routes. However, this will depend on the relaxing of the travel restrictions worldwide and the gradual recovery of global demand for air travel, Al-Raisi said in an interview with Breaking News Travel. Thank you for joining us on the TAS Morning Show. To get the latest updates, log on to theArabianStories.com.